on sulfur and iron. And if the fever is not all right, I have the guts to say now, no, your diagnosis is wrong, it is not malaria. That becomes so thin. There is another disease called leptospirosis. You all have heard about this disease, at least read in the newspapers. But unfortunately, during our college days, we have not heard. Not only us, even the allopathic doctors. Because this is one of the rare occurrences. Even if it is in the exams, it will be a 2-mark or 5-mark question, so nobody wanted to study about it. But now, it is very, very prevalent. Now it is there everywhere. And in Bombay, there was a sudden fever. 23 people died on a single day. Then the doctors realized, oh, it is leptospirosis. So that was the severeness. Simply dying within 24 hours. So how to identify it? We had so many cases. You know how that comes? There are so many stories about this leptospirosis. When a person opened a godown, rice godown, where there is full of rat droppings, and he inhaled it and developed leptospirosis and died. This will affect liver, this will affect kidneys, this will affect brain, lungs, any part of the body. And the symptoms will be like malaria, like typhoid, like jaundice, but it's a combination of all three, that is leptospirosis. Only indication it gives you, immediate indication, is the suffusion of the conjunctiva, or there is a redness in the conjunctiva. I had a patient from Vellore CMC. Some doctor has written beautifully the suffusion of the conjunctiva, all symptoms he has written. Finally, he has concluded as clinical typhoid. If you, except forgetting that, if you see that, it's a 100,000 perfectly taken a case. A very, very knowledge doctor should have done that. So clearly and beautifully written case. But unfortunately, we don't know what is left out.